Hey, what's up, garden friends?
How's everybody doing?
So I came across this Asclepias, this butterfly weed, milkweed, on clearance. It's a very big plant that was in an extremely small pot. The monarchs are starting to do their thing in my area. I'm seeing them fly around and, you know, they're playing with each other. I want to go ahead and get a little pot put together for the butterflies. Help attract them, the monarchs. The milkweed is their host plant. I have a pretty hefty amount of the native milkweed to where I live planted in my garden as well, but I really like this variety.
This variety is the Asclepias Curassavica. It's the more tropical variety, has reddish and yellow flowers on them. I'll show you all that after I get this potted up. And to go with this, I'm gonna go ahead and throw this coneflower in here. This variety is called Cheyenne Spirit.
It has multicolored flowers that go from orange to pink to this kind of like nice creamy peachy color in there. It's one of my favorites of the coneflowers. Now, it would probably seem to make more sense for me to put this in the ground. Problem though with that is that the rabbits absolutely devour coneflowers whenever I plant them. So I thought putting it in a pot just makes more sense. And it has a nice color, the butterflies can feed on it, it's gonna draw them in. It's just cute and pretty. This pot really, it has just about the right amount of size to it for this planting. I'm gonna go ahead and just pull this out of the nursery can. Just kind of gently rub the sides of that root mass a little bit. You can see the bottom's not too twisted up, so I don't really need to worry about that. Just go ahead and pop this guy in there. Okay, not gonna lie, that was a bit of a snug fit. I had this verbena here, one that I picked up on clearance a while ago, and I was gonna put that over the front, but I don't really think there's room. I'm gonna fidget with it for a minute and see if I can't make it work. All right, and I got that done. I just barely managed to squeeze this verbena in here. Like I said, or I think I said, I typically wouldn't be cramming things together quite this tight, but it's August, growing season. There's not a ton left of it. I mean, there's like maybe 2.5 months to 3, depending. So there's still plenty of time, but if it were May, I wouldn't have done it that way.
And I did come in here with my snippers and I kind of gave this guy a cutting
to help encourage it to go ahead and put its roots out and bush out and fill out a little bit more.
This variety of verbena is the Superbino Royale Cherry Burst.
The tag says it'll get about 6 to 12 inches full to part sun. It's a verbena. The Superbino Royale is from Proven Winners. I really have been enjoying them this year. I don't know if this variety is going to be one of my favorites. I haven't seen it in bloom yet. It's red, but I just really wanted a verbena in here. It was really important to me to make sure that every single plant I put in here was something that would attract the butterflies and bees and hummingbirds. Though the main point was to get that milkweed planted in there.
There are the flowers. Aren't those beautiful? I love that pop of red with the yellow. So pretty. Really, I enjoy the flowers on just about all the different milkweed varieties. Oh, that's an annual for me. Whereas this coneflower, that's going to be a perennial.
The fall, when the frost hits and this guy starts to die back, I'll go ahead and I'll cut it all the way down to the surface of the soil and I'll pick this pot up and I'm gonna put it someplace sheltered and make sure to water it about once a month. And then when springtime temperatures start to warm up, I'll water it more frequently and should bounce back. This Cheyenne Spirit coneflower is hardy all the way down to zone 4, I believe, so it should be just fine in a pot, but like I said, I just have to make sure it stays watered in the winter time.
That's it. Quick, easy, simple. Not the most beautiful thing I've ever put together, but that's also, did you see the, what, I just ruined it. There's a really pretty butterfly on there.
But beauty's in the eye of the beholder, and this is for the butterflies. I'm gonna be setting this up in my butterfly garden. Hopefully, since it's raised, the rabbits will leave it alone. The pot's not really that big, so I'm not positive that's going to work, but we will see. So like I said, the monarchs they're flying around everywhere, but not in front of the camera. They're all over the place. They're ready to do their thing. They're ready to lay their eggs and get things going. So it's important that I have this pot up so it'll be a nice, healthy plant for them, for those larvae, for the pupae or whatever you want to call the baby caterpillars, for them to go ahead and feed on this, form their chrysalis, their cocoons, and develop into new monarchs that'll fly down south and come back next year and make more babies. That should be the generation we're on right now. I'm not positive. It's like, I think it's August 5th, so I think the ones that are born right now should be the ones that'll fly down south. They're complicated.
And absolutely fascinating.
But yeah, there it is. Quick, sloppy butterfly planter. In just a few weeks, maybe a week or two, I'm not positive when this video will come out, but check in for that September garden tour, see how well this is filled out, what's changed, and I will be posting updates when the babies and things are growing and crawling around on there.
Also, I don't think I mentioned this Cheyenne Spirit coneflower to adjust the exposure a little bit. There we go. That's more like what it looks like in person. This coneflower smells amazing.
I don't remember my other ones being highly fragrant, so that's interesting. I also had them in the ground and I wasn't like on my hands and knees sniffing my plants, so that probably has something to do with it too.
What are some of your favorite plants to put out there for the butterflies?
Oh, you are thirsty. I need to water you in. Probably going to stick this into the part sun for the time being, just to give it some time to recover from being potted up. But they're pretty tough plants. It should bounce back no problem.
You guys putting the milkweeds in your gardens for those monarchs?
Give them a try. They're really pretty, very rewarding, and they draw on the butterflies like crazy.
Get online with your state's website. You can find the varieties that are native.
There are myths that if you plant this tropical variety that it throws them off from their migration. Pretty much every study I've read says that that's not true at all.
But it's always nice to go native.
Mine are probably not visible, but you can kind of see their little pink tips up there.
But for a nice colorful pot, this is what I like.
So I hope everybody's doing well. Comment down below. Let me know what you're doing with your butterflies, or your pollinator garden, or your favorite pollinator plants. I have all my social media stuff down below in the description of the video. Feel free to follow me and I follow you back, and it's just so much fun seeing everybody's pictures. If you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. It helps the video so much and the channel, and I really do appreciate it. Thank you. Subscribe as well. It's actually down there. And hit that notification bell if you want to see all the videos. I upload multiples a week.
And as always, everybody, most importantly, keep on growing.
Bye-bye.